The story is really a very traditional fairy story. Sinbad the Sailor meets Sleeping Beauty.
Prince's Quest is about two princes named Azure and Asmar.
Two boys, one very privileged, the other the son of a maidservant, brought up together as kids, then separated by cruel fate.
Far away, across the sea, in the land of the Jinn Fairy, the sun always shines. The scent of roses and jasmine fills the air. The houses are white and blue, as in a dream.
Asmar's got a bigger slice than me.
That's not true, it's smaller.
That's not true, he's eaten it all.
Stop arguing, or I won't finish the story.
No!
So what do you say?
Thank you, Nanny.
In their childhood, they've been taught about the mythical Chin Fairy, and they both decide when they grow up they're going to find her and rescue her from her fate, which is much worse than death.
Eventually, Asmar and his mother are chucked out of Azure's palace.
I no longer need you. Leave.
What?
Don't you understand? You're no longer needed. You're dismissed.
But where will we go, the two of us?
That's not my concern.
Where's Azure?
That's not your concern.
He left in a carriage.
Without saying goodbye?
He had other concerns. Get out.
But I need some time to pack my belongings.
No. Everything in this house is mine. You'll leave with the clothes on your back and nothing more. Go.
Asmar.
Leave my house before I lose my temper.
And they're reunited in the hunt for the Jinn Fairy, competing against each other.
And so the quest is all about looking for the Jinn Fairy.
Argus, you're a foreigner.
Like you?
Yes. We need to form a defensive alliance against the locals. I can hardly walk these days. Your legs are strong. My eyesight is great, but yours ain't. I speak the language very, very well. You can hardly say a word. You carry me on your shoulders, and I'll steer and do what talking's necessary.
The angels must have sent you. I was getting utterly desperate, being by myself in this horrible country. Climb up.
Full ahead! The name's Krapu. Yours?
Azure.
That's an odd name.
What do you like?
You might say I'm like you.
The style Michel Osler, the director, has chosen suits the story brilliantly. His figures are human figures are quite stylized. They're not naturalistic portrayals at all. But if I say caricatures, it's wrong. They're not. But a lot of human features, especially eyes, are exaggerated, and that's very important to the story.
My eyes aren't causing you any offence?
You mean because they're blue? I'm too grown up for such childishness.
It's not a translation, it's an adaptation. It always has to be an adaptation, for a whole lot of reasons. The sense of humour, for example, in the country of origin may not be the same sense of humour as the target audience. References which are perfectly obvious to an audience in the country of origin are not at all obvious to the target audience. So it's not a translation, it's always an adaptation.